Nowadays, Government of India has given facility of home isolation to COVID positive persons. Our health care workers or general populations who are having mild symptoms or they are pre-symptomatic or asymptomatic but COVID positive can avail the facility of home isolation. Home isolation is not permitted in persons who are immune compromised, like patients of HIV, like patients receiving chemotherapy, or patients in whom organ transplant has been done and they are taking immunotherapy. As far as patients of diabetes, blood pressure, renal failure, or other diseases is concerned, and if the patients are above 60 years, then these patients will be examined by medical officers, and if they will deem fit, they will allow for home isolation. Now question comes, what are the prerequisites of home isolation? Whosoever is opting for home isolation should have separate room with attached toilet. He or she should also have the quarantine facility for all the family members. This room should be proper ventilated and the person should be well aware of all the symptoms which he or she can develop. Person should be able to self-monitor pulse, temperature, respiration, and oxygen saturation. That means there should be availability of digital thermometer and pulse oximeter as well. Now question comes, what a caregiver should do? Ideally, there should be only one caregiver for this home isolated patient. This caregiver should take prophylaxis of either hydroxychloroquine or ivermectin as per recent government guidelines. Just nowadays, Government of India has issued that ivermectin 12 mg can be taken on day 1, day 7 and day 30 for prophylaxis. As far as routine of the patient is concerned, the patient should clean his or her area, including floor, doorknobs, handles, bed, bed surfaces, bed table, with suitable sanitization. That means the metallic surfaces, they should be sanitized with alcohol 70% to 90%, and non-metallic surfaces, they should be sanitized with 1% hypochlorite solution. The patient who is home isolated should be monitored every morning and evening, and there should be proper communication with the health authority as well as the caregiver. If this person develops any warning symptoms like high fever, persistent cough, or there is development of drowsiness, or oxygen saturation falls below 95%, immediately the person as well as the caregiver, they should contact hospital and accordingly treatment should be done. Patient who is allowed for home isolation should download Arogya Setu app and home isolation app. He or she should fill all the required information regularly. Moreover, the patient has to sign an undertaking in which person declares that he or she is able to monitor health as well as the person is having all the facilities required for home isolation. Now question comes, what this patient should not do? दिस पेशेंट हु इज होम आइसोलेटेड शुड नॉट मिक्स अप विद अदर फैमिली मेंबर्स, शुड नॉट शेयर बेड और बेड क्लोथ्स, टॉवल्स, हैंकरचीफ, यूटेंसिल्स, शुड नॉट ईट फूड विद अदर फैमिली मेंबर्स. एंड वॉट दिस पर्सन शुड डू अपार्ट फ्रॉम टेकिंग मेडिसिन रेगुलरली, अपार्ट फ्रॉम टेकिंग केयर ऑफ हेल्थ एंड वाइटल्स रेगुलरली, ही और शी शुड रिमेन हैप्पी बाई डूइंग वेरियस इंटरटेनमेंट प्रोसीजर्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, 8 hours स्लीप इज मैंडेटरी. गुड अमाउंट ऑफ फ्लूइड शुड बी टेकन सो दैट प्रॉपर हाइड्रेशन शुड बी देयर. शुड फॉलो ऑल द एटिकेट्स विच आर नेसेसरी फॉर प्रिवेंटिंग द इन्फेक्शन, लाइक वेयरिंग ट्रिपल लेयर मास्क ऑल द टाइम, डूइंग हैंड सैनिटाइजर रेगुलरली, एंड इफ एट ऑल ही और शी कम्स इन कॉन्टैक्ट विद सम अदर फैमिली मेंबर, शुड मेंटेन ए सोशल डिस्टेंस मोर देन 6 feet. द पर्सन और द पेशेंट हु इज होम आइसोलेटेड शुड कीप हिज माइंड पीसफुल बाई डूइंग मेडिटेशन, by doing some exercises within the room, by doing yogasan. The Surya Namaskar is a very good yogasan. It includes movement of all the parts of the body. Regular exercise in form of some dance or physical activity. He or she may watch TV and mimic the activity what are being done. Some good serial, inspirational story, reading books, writing some good things, doing some creative work, talking to friends, talking to family members, all of these things are to be continued so that family members should not get panic and the person who is home isolated should not feel lonely. I want to emphasize one very important thing. When patient is using mask and gloves, he or she should know how to dispose it. Ideally, mask and gloves used by home isolated patient should be dipped in 1% sodium hypochlorite for 30 minutes and then it should be buried or it should be burned as per government guidelines or as per WHO guidelines. But if suppose the facility of burning and burial is not available, then mask and gloves should be cut through help of scissors and kept in a paper bag, left for 72 hours as such, preferably in sun, and then disposed with normal waste. Now question comes, when home isolation should be discontinued? Normally, home isolation is for 10 days and when patient is not having any symptom for last 3 days without medicine, then home isolation is taken as completed. As per government guidelines, even test is not necessary. But yes, after home isolation, as per present protocol, 7 days of home quarantine is also needed. That means, from start of home isolation up to the end of home quarantine, it is a period of 17 days. For 17 days, a COVID infected patient will remain separated from family members. This person should also take care that he or she should not move in common places of the home like dining places or a drawing room or the lawn. In this way, if a person is going to follow the principles of home isolation, he will be a safe and responsible person as well as keep him or herself happy and others happy.